This week for ELA, we're focusing on the letters I, J, and K, ending with a jammy day on Friday to celebrate the letter J. We're also talking about the sight word my. So the stories we're reading this week are full of my, my words. So when you're reading at home, try to find the word my in the stories you're looking at. For comprehension, we're still focusing on making predictions. So looking at what is happening on this page and guessing what might happen on the next page. We're also working on making inferences, which means that by looking at the clues, can you figure out what is happening? It might not be said in the words, but your brain can figure out using the picture and the word clues. And the last thing we're practicing this week is deleting part of a word. So if the word is watermelon, can you say that word without water? So it would just be melon, right? Or if I had the word Grayson, what's Grayson without the gray? It's just sun. So we're taking a word, splitting it into syllables, and deleting a syllable. Can you do it? For math this week, we are first talking about how to tell the difference between a rectangle and a square. So today, we practice saying that a square has the same size sides. It all starts with S, square, same size sides. And a rectangle is different because its sides are not always the same size. So that's one thing we're working on. We are working on identifying the numbers 1 through 10 and putting them in order. We're also working on comparing numbers 1 through 10. So if I gave you the numbers 3 and 7, could you tell me which one is greater and which one is less? And even harder, how many more is 7 than 3? Or how many fewer is 3 than 7? Our social lessons this week are all about listening, focusing, and following directions. So we're going to continue to review the listening rules, which are eyes are looking, ears are listening, voice is quiet, body is still. Every day when we do our social lesson, Puppy comes to visit. This is Puppy. Puppy sometimes has trouble following those listening rules, so the kids have to help him remember. Today, we also started talking about what it means to focus your attention. So we got a new tool. It's called our attentoscopes, and they look like this. We sometimes pretend like we have them on, sometimes we really get them out, but they help us to focus on what we're supposed to be thinking about. So if your teacher is talking, you have your attentoscopes. You might have them actually out, but sometimes we practice where we're just pretending that they're on, and you'll look at your teacher, and nothing else should be distracting you. That is how you focus. When you focus, you use your eyes, your ears, and your brain. And when you focus, it helps you to be able to follow directions. So we're going to be practicing using our attentoscopes all week to help us focus, listen, and follow directions. This week for handwriting, we are going to be practicing 4 more frog jump letters. Frog jump letters are a big line letter. They start at the top. They're a big line letter. Do the big line drop. So they start at the top. They drop down. You jump back up to the top to finish your letter. So those 4 letters we're practicing this week are D, P, B, and R. They all start at the top. They all have a big line down and a frog jump up before you finish them out. Last but not least, our theme for this week is all about me. So we're going to be talking about all the different things that make each of us special, like our names. We're going to be doing a few projects that have to do with our names. We're also going to be using those pictures I've been taking from our home visits to talk about what we like to do and how that makes us each special.